Hi, everybody. Welcome to today's episode of the Train Your Dog With Me series. Today, we're going to follow up with Lindsey and see how her first week with Winnie went. And today, we're going to learn how to do down. And we're also going to do a little bit more desensitization to like nail clippers, sounds, and we're going to introduce Winnie to a vacuum.
Good, how are you?
Good. How was your first week with puppy training?
Okay, we've made some really good improvements. I feel like what you showed me last week, she's pretty much a pro at right here and even in like other rooms of the house. But if we go outside, like if we're on a walk, like she won't listen, which is fine. You told me that's normal.
Yeah. So I like to explain it kind of like, so dogs don't generalize. Mm-hmm. And so think about in here as like preschool, mm-hmm. and out in the yard is like elementary school, mm-hmm. and then outside on a walk would be like high school, and she's still in preschool. So that's one of the things that, I mean, I hear this all the time. It's like, my dog did this perfect at home and now at puppy class. I'm like, because we're at a doggy daycare where there's all these smells and other dogs and other people. So that's where all the extra training just comes in.
And I know what's in your hand.
And while we're talking, I'm going to be rewarding her for sitting.
Okay.
Because she's doing so good to just sit politely, which requires me to multitask.
Yeah.
so that's one of the ongoing training things is just, I like to tell people to train, you know, in different places with different people. Okay. Because even my dogs will mind me really well, but then if I hand them off to somebody, they might be like, oh, you're not my owner. I don't need to do that.
Okay. I've been using our morning training. It's been just like me and her, but then we have the kids and my husband come in the evening one. It's kind of how we've
been doing it. That's perfect.
Okay.
Yeah. So it's totally normal for her to be more distracted, on walks and things like that.
Okay.
And one thing you can do, like, does she get just distracted with other people or other dogs?
Yes. So let me tell you kind of what she's doing. And I'm assuming this is normal, but maybe there's a way we can help this. So she gets really scared, which that's probably normal with her size. I don't know. So this last week, what we've done is we had a friend bring over a big dog. She was terrified. And like my friend was telling me, she's like, oh, our dog plays with little dogs a lot. He just kind of plays really good. But she didn't want anything to do with playing with him. If he was sitting there, she'd kind of like sniff at him, but she would let out like the terrified, like yelpy kind of scared, you know? And so, I mean, that didn't go great, but I guess it was maybe good for her to be around him.
So what I would do in that situation,
she's like,
hey, look, they're down here. Is I would pick her up and you want to make sure that you don't like baby or coddle her because then that's reinforcing for them. And they learn, oh, if I act scared, mom will baby me. But it is absolutely okay to pick her up if she's afraid, and then you can do things like, oh, look at that big dog, look at me, watch, yes, and then reward that, and just pair like the other dog with treats and have her start to associate other dogs equal treats. And good sit.
Okay. And so we're kind of seeing, sorry.
Oh, and then you know, while you're holding her, just be like, oh, look, there's a dog. And then focus on me. Yes, good girl.
Okay, that's good.
And so that she just sees another dog, associates treats, sees another dog. Mm-hmm. And then I always like to let, dogs meet other dogs on their comfort level.
Okay.
So like if you have a good dog and 1 week I can bring my dog and I can show you.
That'd be awesome.
I usually put them like in a sit or a down and then, yes. And then let the puppy decide to go up and sniff, and then just lots of praise. Mm-hmm. But then if the puppy is afraid and wants to back away, I let them. I don't ever force them to meet another dog that they're not comfortable with.
Okay. So you want them with a dog that's not also like hyper like them in the beginning.
Yeah. You can either get a puppy that's about her age and size or a really good adult dog. Mm-hmm. She's trying to hand target.
Yes. See, we worked on it.
I know. That's awesome. Good job, Winnie. Another dog her size or a really good adult dog that's calm.
Okay.
That will just let her kind of approach at her. Because, like, really rambunctious dogs could maybe scare her.
Yeah.
And we don't want her to be afraid of other dogs.
Okay, yes. That's what I was wondering about. So, on a one walk, we saw a neighbor who had It's like a little golden doodle, like the exact same age, a little bigger than her, but they were really good together, just sniffing each other. And yeah. They were both on leashes, so they weren't playing really, but she was good.
Okay.
And then we walked. She doesn't love dogs barking. And so she hears one like down the hill a little bit, like from far away, and it kind of freaks her out. But we went on a walk and there were these two little dogs. We're like, oh, let's walk by their house. They're in their backyard behind the fence. But they were kind of crazy, so we wanted to see kind of what she did. And she freaked. She, like, yelping, jumped up into my arms. And so I held her, but let her just, like, watch them.
Yeah, good.
And I didn't know if that was the right thing.
That is, okay. Yeah. So in puppy classes, we do the exact same thing, where if a puppy is, like, hiding behind your legs, mm-hmm. I tell the owners to pick the puppy up and just let them watch.
Okay.
And just let them watch.
Okay.
So let's just review. She's already doing great with sit, touch.
Yes.
Good job.
We even tried. One day she touched my elbow, but I think it might have been by accident because she's never done it again.
Touch. Yes. Good girl. Okay, so today we're going to do down.
Okay.
And I'm going to show you, I don't know yet if we're going to have to shape it or if we can lure it, but I'm going
to. I tried to lure it, and I can't seem to do it.
Treat down.
She just kind
of... Okay, so I'm going to shape it, which means we're going to take it in little segments.
Okay.
So first, I'm just taking nose to ground, click and treat.
Okay. Ooh. Eating so fast.
She's like, I got to make sure I get through that whole bag. So I do that several times, and then I'm going to slowly start to move it out, and I just want one paw to move. Sometimes you have to be really patient with this.
Uh-huh. Because we're trying to get our stuff outwards, huh?
Yeah. Here, let's reset you. Over here. Sit. And if you need to go back to step one ever, you can.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, I'm going to give that to her because she's reaching out more.
With her, okay.
Yeah. So anything new that she gives me into that down position...
Could it be because she's so little and close to the floor, or do bigger dogs kind of struggle with this?
They do too.
Okay.
Yeah, one of my pit mixes, it literally took me 2 months to do this.
Really?
And we finally, I'll show you what we had to do with her. What is this? You want this?
I just think she's the funniest thing ever. I'm sure every dog owner thinks that.
Plus she kind of thinks I'm playing.
Yeah.
So I might just click if a paw moves. Oh, she actually did a little bit of a bend in her elbow, so I'm going to click and treat for that.
Okay.
Now, there's also something called capturing where we just wait for her to go into a down and then get ready to mark and treat.
Like just any time?
Yeah.
Now so is she just laying there?
Yeah. So, well, I wait for her to like lay down. Now, that one I clicked and treated because this paw was forward.
Okay.
So that was like a little bit closer. And some dogs don't get this on the very first. Some dogs go right down. Oh, good job. So did you see her little paw move?
Yep.
So this is called shaping, where we just take the behavior and break it into little. And then if she gets frustrated, then we're going to like end on a good one.
Uh-huh.
And then practice another time.
Okay.
Eventually, we wait for a paw to move and then another paw, and then eventually she will just plop right down.
Mm-hmm.
Sometimes I've had dogs, like we've done it on the
tile
mm-hmm. and they kind of slide into a down.
Okay.
So this is how we had to do it with Daphne. So I had the treat and I lured her under my leg.
Oh.
And then she just went down.
Oh, yeah. Yeah.
So I clicked and treated.
So you clicked and treated when her...
But her front went down. Her back ended up going down. If
uh-huh.
I would have known she would go all the way down, I would have waited to
click.
Yeah, play.
Okay.
But...
You're still moving it forward?
Yep.
Okay.
Good job!
That's a good idea.
Good! So then when she falls into that down, then I click treat.
Okay.
And I would do this a lot before you name it down. Because right now, if I just say, like, Winnie down, she's not going to know what it means.
Okay.
And I don't want her to like, start ignoring the cue.
Yeah, yeah.
So I would click and treat for this part, like, several times.
Okay. Winnie! Good girl! Yeah, good girl! Was such a good girl!
Good distraction and listening to her name.
Yeah.
Good job.
She's doing really good with that.
Winnie! Sit. Yeah, let's try this one again and see. And it's so interesting how you have to do different things with different dogs.
Oh, yeah.
Good job.
Oh, what a good girl.
And once she goes into that position, like, 5 to 7 times,
uh-huh.
then you can start naming it down.
Okay. And we don't say down until she's down, right, for a while?
Yeah. Well, once you can lure her down or shape her into a down, then I will, and I'm actually going to, see, she just did it.
Yeah.
And she didn't even have to go under my leg.
Right.
So I'll show you kind of how I name it. Can you go back up into a sit? Oh, good job.
Good
so
girl.
Those are called puppy push-ups.
Oh, just going from down to sit.
And then sit to down to sit to down.
Okay. Oh, cute.
So in class, we have puppy push-up contests.
Right.
Prizes. So then I would kind of exaggerate and say down.
Yeah,
like
good
with
the
job.
Way I'm saying it.
Yeah.
Okay.
At first.
Uh-huh.
And then after she gets it, then I just say down.
Okay. So how does that help? Just, yeah,
just
to learn the word?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah. And then because I'm luring her down with the treat, this is my hand signal for down,
okay.
which you don't, I wouldn't do right now. I would just teach her the verbal cue.
Okay.
Let's see if you can do sit again.
She's like, that's too far back there.
Yes, good job.
Good girl.
Down.
Aww.
Good.
Yes.
Good
girl, sweetie.
And then I wanted to do a little bit of social, like teach her how to get her used to clippers, Dremel, you know, other things.
Yeah. What is a Dremel for?
Nails.
Instead of clippers?
Yeah.
Okay.
For her age, I just use regular nail clippers,
uh-huh.
or I use cat nail clippers because
okay.
they're smaller.
Uh-huh.
I use a Dremel on my dogs just because then you can't quick them.
Mm.
And we want to make sure that we don't quick them because if you do it once, then they're like, oh, you're never touching my paws again.
Yeah, yeah.
So then it's hard.
So what do you think about, the vet told me to get some, what is it called? Some stuff that helps if they do start bleeding.
Yes,
like,
it's like styptic powder.
Yeah, I didn't get that.
Yeah.
Should I get that?
I have it just in case, because sometimes I clip and then Dremel.
Okay.
Yeah, it's a good idea to have it, just because they can bleed a lot from that if you get that quick.
Mm-hmm.
But I'll kind
and
of...
And by quick, you mean like cutting into the pink.
Yeah. What I'm going to do is I'm going to show her the clippers and then give her a treat, and then they both go behind my back. And you can use this with regular clippers, Dremel, anything.
Okay.
You can even do this with a brush. Like
how
if
often
you're gonna
should
brush
I be clipping nails?
Just when you hear them click on the
okay.
tile. And you can let the groomer do it.
Mm-hmm.
But if you do this foundation stuff first, the vet will love you.
Okay.
If they can just go in and
yeah.
clip your nails. Or if they can clip her nails. So the scary thing, the clippers predict the treat. So we're creating that positive association
uh-huh.
between clippers. Oh, good girl. And then I let her sniff them.
Uh-huh.
And then treat. And then you're... going to be handling her paws
mm-hmm.
anyway, like when you handle her paws and in between her toes and
mm-hmm.
stuff. So now I'm just going to touch her foot with the clippers and treat.
Okay.
And I do allow her, if she wants to pull her foot back,
mm-hmm.
that's fine.
Okay.
I don't ever force her.
Mm-hmm.
So I'm going to touch, treat. Good job. And so, like, with a brush, a grooming brush, I do the same thing, and then I'll actually, like, brush them with the backside of the brush
mm-hmm.
before I do the bristles.
Okay.
And then I might, like, bring this out, make the clipping sound,
mm-hmm.
and then back.
Okay.
And, yeah, if you get her groomed regularly, like, you
yeah.
probably don't ever have to do it.
Okay.
I'll probably do
okay.
it for you. So I touch. Good girl. Good job.
Yeah, that's awesome.
So now I'm going to get a treat ready because I'm actually going to just touch a nail. Oh, good job. That was so good. And so we just take that whole process of clipping the nail and break it down mm-hmm. into like clippers treats, touch your paw treats, okay. touch your paw with the clippers treat. Mm-hmm. So I usually do like one at a time. Uh-huh. And this is what I love the licky mats for. Uh-huh. Because I'll give a dog a licky mat to keep them distracted. Like distracted. Yeah. In fact, I'm going to give you a couple treats.
Okay.
And I'm going to let you give her treats while I clip one back toe.
Okay.
And then I'm going to treat her for
okay.
doing that. So
here, look. Winnie, what your Winnie has. Winnie. Treat. Sometimes she doesn't want the treat when she's distracted. Is that normal?
Yeah. And actually, you can pick her up. Okay. You can pick her up and give her a couple treats, and that will give me easier access to her little back paw.
Winnie, look. Look.
Yes, good girl. Good girl. It's okay. Yes. So if she wiggles, I'm going to let her back
okay.
away.
Okay.
Good girl.
Good girl.
Because if she knows that I'm not going to force her, then she'll be more apt to, like, let me do it.
Okay.
And it's kind of like when you go to the dentist and he says, raise your hand if you feel pain and I'll stop.
Yeah.
So if she doesn't like it, I'm going to totally back away.
Okay.
But eventually, and I start with just the very tip of the nail. Uh-huh. And then I'll clip and immediately treat.
Okay.
Let's do the dog barking first.
Okay.
So with sound socialization, you can use apps, you can use YouTube, anything that has sounds. And we're going to do this with a vacuum too to show her how to get used to the vacuum.
Okay.
I start with a really low volume. Mm-hmm. And this one is first like a small yap. Oh, I gotta put it on. So when she hears the sound, I pair it with treats. Mm-hmm. And then when the sound stops, the treats stop.
Okay.
And she handled that great, so I'm gonna turn it up. Okay, now I'm gonna do a medium bark.
See that?
What is that? So, since she was a little bit startled with uh-huh. that one, I'm going to back off on the volume.
Okay.
So that's why I like using this, so I can control the volume.
Okay.
Hey, Winnie!
You're a good girl.
What's that? Here, look. What is that? What is that? I know, is that dog barking?
Yeah, it's like the deeper barks that really get her.
Good girl. But she's still taking treats, which is good. So okay. I'm actually going to back off a little bit more because we always want to do it at a threshold that she can handle.
Okay. So do you good feel girl. Like hearing it on the phone does translate into like, what if she saw the dog and it was barking?
Yeah.
Is that
well, in that way... Yeah, it can be scarier uh-huh. because it's loud.
Yeah.
And so I like to start with the sound really soft and mm-hmm. then slowly build up to loud mm-hmm. and then transition into actually seeing dogs.
Okay, okay.
And that's why I like to do the apps. Mm-hmm. Let's play. Can we just play? Oh, yes, good girl.
She's like, I know you. That's where the dog came.
Good girl.
Good girl.
So let me see if I can kind of like move this behind me. Good girl. So that was pretty soft.
Yeah.
So we always want to start it to where she can just barely hear it and
okay.
then slowly increase volume. Hey, what's this over here? What's that?
Is she not wanting it?
No, she's taking it. She's just kind of looking around.
Yeah.
If she was really startled, I'd back off on the volume again. Uh-huh. Mm-hmm. But I would just go at her pace, too. Mm-hmm. So,
okay.
like there's no time limit. Like, oh, we have to get to full volume today.
Yeah, yeah.
Just do this a little bit every day.
Okay.
And then you can do this with any sound.
Yeah, yeah. It's funny because she's fine in the car. She's fine with the vacuum, actually. When we try that, you'll see. I mean, hopefully she does. It's with you here. But, like, it's dogs that scare her.
So, you can... I'm sure there's free apps for dog barking or YouTube.
Okay.
And then you can control the volume mm-hmm. and just let her, like, hear them from a distance.
Mm-hmm.
and be like, oh, that's a dog, treat, treat. Mm-hmm. As long as she hears the dog barking, treat. And then okay. when the dog stops barking, the treats stop.
Okay.
So we're pairing sound of dogs with high value treats. Mm-hmm. And then when there's no sound, no treats.
Okay.
And then you can slowly turn it up. Okay. And if she does act a little startled, then back off on the sound a little bit.
Okay.
Okay, so let's grab your vacuum.
Yeah.
And what we're going to do with this, you can do with brooms, vacuums, wet vacs. I've done it with skateboards, cross-country skis.
This one right here?
Yeah, so we're just going to pretend like she's afraid of the vacuum.
Okay.
Oh, good girl. So she's sniffing it, so I'm going to give her a treat. Here, Winnie. For dogs that don't really want to approach, I would mm-hmm. start a treat out here.
Okay, just get them used to coming closer.
Yep. And then, and you can do the same thing with, like, dogs that don't like to get in the car.
Mm-hmm.
We actually did this yesterday with a dog.
Okay.
We started way out here and then got closer.
To the car?
Yeah.
Uh-huh.
And then we put a treat, like, right on the edge of the car.
Uh-huh.
Hey, Winnie, look, what's this? Good girl. Good job. So we're pairing the vacuum with treats.
Okay.
And then I'm going to just very, like, slightly move it. Oh, good girl.
Oh, good girl. Treat.
Good girl, Winnie. Good.
So you're just showing her that it moves.
Yep.
Yeah.
Without the sound.
Okay.
Good job. And you can do this with, like, my dogs like to chase the lawnmower and bark uh-huh. at the wheels.
Yeah.
So this is what I would do
mm-hmm.
with it. I think with them, it's more of a game.
Yeah, but right. They want to do that.
Yeah. Good girl, Winnie.
Good.
Good job.
Just checking it out.
So now, without the vacuum moving, now I'm going to do the sound.
Okay.
And I'm going to start it soft. And we're going to start with just on, off, on, off. And since she's kind of used to the vacuum, I'm not even at half volume, but I'm going to start with.
Okay.
So as soon as she hears the sound, mm-hmm. I start to treat. When the sound stops, the treat stops.
Okay.
Good job. And then she did great with that, so I'm going to turn it up a little bit. Let me break a few of these. This also kind of sounds like a blender, so you could use the same one for a blender.
Yeah, okay. Good girl, Winnie.
Good job. Oh, what a brave girl. Good girl. Good girl. And then once you get to full volume, like on an app, mm-hmm. then you could actually plug the actual vacuum in and go on, off, treat.
Okay.
And then start to move it a little bit.
Yeah.
And so you take the whole act of vacuuming
mm-hmm.
and just break it down into little, like, first here's a vacuum.
Okay.
And then here is it moving. Mm-hmm. And then you can do the same thing with bikes. Like, if you get a dog used to bikes when they're young, then mm-hmm. they won't chase bikes.
Oh,
so
okay.
I do the same thing. Like, I put treats right by the wheels, and then I move the bike a little bit, treat, and then I have somebody get on and just kind of move, walk with it, treat,
uh-huh.
and then ride. So,
like, there are some other. So we've got, like, vacuum, the car, bikes, blender. What else would they?
So anything that she's going to be introduced to, kind of in your lifestyle. So,
okay.
like, if you guys bike, I would get her used to bikes.
Mm-hmm.
Obviously, brooms, vacuums. Mm-hmm. I kayak, so I always get my dogs used to kayaks.
Okay, just so when you're getting it out and moving it around.
Yeah, and they actually ride with me.
Oh, cool. That's awesome.
So, but if you never kayak, you don't have to really do that.
Yeah, sure.
And so in your puppy packet from last week, there's a socialization checklist,
uh-huh.
and it just gives you ideas of stuff.
Okay.
So you can do, like, baby strollers,
mm-hmm.
Bikes, I don't even know what all the new things are called that kids are riding now.
Yeah, I don't actually.
I saw one yesterday. I'm like, I would break my neck.
Yeah.
And that, it was bizarre. But anything that your kids, you know.
Right. Like the hoverboard, we have the little hoverboard thing.
Yeah, the hoverboard thing, yeah. You can do that.
That has kind of freaked her out, actually.
Yeah.
To see the kids come riding through the house on it. She's like, what is that?
Yeah. So, like, put it still and let her sniff it, put a treat on it, and then slowly move it.
Yeah.
And then, like, if kids come over, you can have them just toss treats to her. Mm-hmm. So she's like, oh, kids equal treats or strangers equal treats.
Yeah, she loves strangers.
Oh, good.
She has no stranger danger at all.
That's really good. That's really good.
I mean, we had, you know, some repair people come to the door, and she was, like, all about them, and she just loves people. It's dogs that she's nervous about.
Yeah. And so we'll work on that a little bit. Next week, I'll bring one of my dogs.
Okay,
and
cool.
I'll just kind of show you how to introduce.
Yeah, that'd be awesome.
Get her used to it. And then, yeah, socialize her with her mom, with the doodle that's really good with her, just so she gets some socialization.
Yeah, yeah.
And things like that. So.
Okay.
So this week, you're going to work on down, and I'll send you the handout on down.
Okay.
And then continue with the body handling.
Uh-huh.
You can do the kind of the association with clippers.
Okay.
And you don't even have to actually clip. Just like touch her nail.
Uh-huh.
I actually will take a dog's nail and flick it with my fingernail.
Okay.
So that they just feel something hard on there.
Uh-huh.
Touch her paw with the clippers.
Mm-hmm.
And then pick one different thing a day to kind of introduce her to. Like, oh, today's the vacuum. Here's the dustpan. Here's the broom, here's a bike, here's a hoverboard.
Mm-hmm.
Just like
now, if she's like doing well, like with the vacuum, it didn't seem to bother her. Like, do we kind of just move on from that?
Yeah.
Okay.
Then it's like, okay, she's good with the vacuum.
Yeah.
Let's move on to something else.
And then if I ever notice her like not being good with the vacuum, then we kind of start over.
Yeah. Then you can always back up.
Okay.
Yep.
Cool. So there's no need to like keep with the vacuum if she seems to be fine.
Oh, does she need to go potty?
She did.
Yeah.
Nice.
Hey, that was our bad for not paying attention. And I was just talking to a veterinarian yesterday about how much exercise is okay for
down
dogs.
Uh-huh.
And he tells clients, just do what your dog can do.
Okay.
So, like, a dog, Winnie's size, isn't going to be able to do, like, 5 miles.
Yeah, right.
But when I had a puppy, we would do 7 miles a day, and we were hiking, like, uphill.
Yeah.
And he could make it, and this was before I knew, like, you're not supposed to hike until their growth plate's closed.
Oh,
back.
Okay.
So, but he did really good on
the way up. So no
hiking,
but walking is fine.
Yeah, walking is fine.
Yeah.
And even, like, slight inclines. He said to be more careful about the shoulders, like not letting her jump off of couches or jump off of beds.
Because
it can be hard on the shoulder joints and the elbows.
So is my hill that we live on, is that too steep?
No.
Okay.
That's fine.
Because we walk her up that every day.
Yep.
Okay.
She's totally fine doing that. And then just do what she can handle.
Mm-hmm.
And then, you know, when she's tired, she'll let you know she's tired, and then you can carry her.
Okay. She's getting better with her crate, going in and out. That helped so much.
Oh, good.
She wasn't going in on her own at all until we started doing that. We're still struggling with, like, getting the whole family to leave the house so that she can go in her crate because we're all home all the time.
Yeah.
But, yeah, we usually find a time, like, a little bit each day.
Good. Yeah, that's all you need is just a little bit and then, like, build up just so she learns to be alone and that you're going to come back.
Okay. Oh, one question. So if we're, like, on Sunday, we were gone for, like, an hour and 20 minutes. And so I didn't know if she would pee in her crate. And so we just put her in her little pen area with the potty pad. I don't think she used it. I don't remember. Is that the best? Can she go in her crate for that long at this age?
Yeah, for an hour. Yeah, she would be fine.
Okay. She can just, we just take her out before and...
Yep. Yeah, I would take her out potty before and then put her in her crate. And that kind of teaches dogs to hold it.
Okay.
Because they don't like to pee where they sleep.
Yeah, yeah.
And so, yeah, she would be fine for an hour.
Okay.
Yeah, she did great this week.
Yeah, she picked up on everything, like, really fast. I think the down will be trickier.
Yeah.
But
yeah, so just get on the ground and do the little bridge.
Okay. Cool.
And then click right when she goes all the way down.
Okay. Okay, perfect.
Yeah, good job.
Yay!
And as you're following along in these episodes, make sure that you check out the episode details for important links to handouts, articles, and other really important things that will help you on this puppy training journey.